Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to my guide for Singed. I wanted to do something different, so I figured I wanna make a video about my main champ in League of Legends. And I think the game turned out to be a good video for a guide. It's not that long. And I think I get to show off a little in some instances. But I will also do some mistakes. So I think there's quite a lot to learn here. If you wanna play Singed on the top lane. Yeah, I have to admit that I haven't played normal games in a while. This is Team Builder, and I got the info that I'm getting paired with not so experienced player because I have been inactive for such a long time in the normal mode. So this is definitely one reason why I'm doing rather good in this, even though I'm not playing really perfect. And first of all, I really like to hide in the bush, like I just did there, just so I get a good angle on my enemy to give him a little bit of poison damage. It's nearly time. And right now, Darius must be thinking he's good, but he's actually not, because I have Trinket. I'm not sure it's called in English, this Trinket. You know, the Trinket for 345. Yeah, and just back there, Darius made a great mistake by taking super much poison just for getting one CS, and now it will cost him a whole lot of CS because now I can zone him out, and this is like a really important. Yeah, okay, wait, I will just get rid of this guy because he came too close. Not enough HP. I stopped the gas so I can get enough mana for a flank. It's also really, really important if you have a little bit of a prolonged fight or some kind of rumble. In the early stages and the later stages, you will of course leave your gas on, just in case. But in the early stages, you really have to pay attention that you don't run around with the gas all the time, even if you're fighting, just because your fling costs a whole lot of mana and is really important if you're chasing somebody. Because if you're really chasing, your gas won't do much because it's behind you and you really want to get your fling up. And as you could maybe saw in the previous fight with Darius, I managed to get it up right in time, the mana for it, because I put my poison off. Singed is a hell lot of micromanagement. Singed, I don't think many people realize. I've seen people stating, oh, you just have to put on your Q and you will get a million CS. And that's definitely not the case. If you're winning your lane, that maybe is the case. But it's really important for Singed to not farm under the tower. Singed is maybe one of the worst farmers if he's really zoned out, because gas with its overtime damage is not really reliable on doing last hits. So you gotta stand by and make sure you hit him in the right time, not like I did there, but like I did there. Yeah. And against Darius, it's it's really painful micromanagement, because against most champions you would love to just be brawling with them like 24/7, but Darius will put his blood tier stacks on him, on you, and yeah, if you got 4 stacks or 5 stacks, this will do actually more than your poison damage, and he also has like his normal attacks. Yeah. Well timed gank by Lee. My engage was maybe a little early, but I did want to engage before he would spot Lee. So I think the timing was okay in this instant. Maybe a little bit of left. Yeah, now you got to do the great thing with Singed, which is farming behind the tower. And I think I really make a mistake right there by hitting the tower. I would have got a much longer lane dominance if I just would have kept the tower alive longer. Just because it's very easy to zone your enemy out if you're fighting at this tower, but as you will see in a few minutes, it will be very tough at the other tower. I know this is also really, really bad. I'm wasting precious time here. I already backing, but I decide that I wanna annoy Darius a little, just so he can catch up, but I have no mana. That means I have to go back anyway, and he will get all the CS also, so that was really pointless and just delayed me by maybe 30 or 40 seconds, and I would be maybe already close to being back in lane again right now if I hadn't done this. Yeah, so that was one of the mistakes that I also wanted to show you, and I think it's pretty crucial. Just because really don't want to waste your time. Another mistake I think right there, buying the giant spell. Because when I'm dominating my lane, I want to push the domination further, which means getting more damage. I'm also already pretty comfortably surviving his attacks, so I just should get more damage so I can kill him faster. Yeah, and I'm going for the tier. Sometimes I'm going for the Rod of Ages instead. I think you should really just pick one of them, even though like the mana bonus stacks each other if you finish both rods. But it will somehow just take space in your inventory. Yeah, you will have a little bit of more damage and more HP, but you don't really have any cool abilities like Rylai's Scepter would, for example, give you, and this build is pretty much meant to rush Rylai's Scepter, getting only the Tear of Goddess, maybe boots and the potion. For me, I definitely get the potion on Singed. You can maybe get Doran's instead, but I would really recommend this 345 trinket thingy that always reloads at base. It's really nice to have. And the tier might also be a slightly better tool than how is this thing called? I think Runic Crystal or something, like the crystal you have to get to build your Rod of Ages. It's pretty expensive and it doesn't do that much for you in the lane. I feel like I always die just right before leveling when I would get the passive HP. Yeah, and now you can see I have really a hard time fighting him under his tower, and I'm doing something really, really stupid. I forgot about his ultimate, and to forget about Darius' ultimate is so, so bad in so many ways. I was far ahead and I got still killed, and that's the power of Darius' ultimate end of his passive. As I mentioned before, I really didn't care much about his tier stacks, and they shredded me apart. And his ulti after that, yeah. If I'm behind against Darius, I saw his ulti taking more than half of my HP, which makes for a ridiculous, impossible lane. So I was pretty proud of myself to, yeah, at least not do that bad against this Darius here. But still, he shouldn't be a very experienced player, and he doesn't really play like one. But yeah, I have actually seen many good players just forfeiting many CS just to not feed to me. And I really, really hate that. I also really hate that gank right there. I could have avoided it by maybe getting a ward. So I gave him back 2 kills in a short time. Which is one of my main flaws generally when I'm playing, and I'm not really planning on sacrificing my aggressiveness. I should maybe ward more when I'm playing that aggressive. But Singed really has to play aggressive to get his CS advantage in game. Of course, an even lane is also a good lane for Singed in most cases, just because Singed is a pretty mid to late game champ, maybe falling off a little in the very late game, like if everybody has a full items build. Sometimes some people just shred too much with it or burst you too hard. But in the mid and early late game, Singed is a very, very nice champion. Yeah, and now it's really funny again, I'm again getting too much of his tier stacks, like constantly 5 stacks. And I'm really close to getting down there, but getting the health pots in and my ultimate I can regenerate my HP fast enough. Now I'm just going back to the farm. So if Darius follows me there, I'm pretty sure I can kill him. And I'm also pretty sure that he's still in the bushes there. Yeah, now I saw him. And somehow, at least the boost of the dragon gave me the confidence to fight here. And this was a really bad fling. Actually pretty good played by Darius. I mean, it was an even fight, we both traded summoners, but I could have got him. If I would have flinked him into my gas and not into nowhere, I'm pretty sure he would have been down and dead. And maybe I didn't really need to burst, to waste my ghost. I'm not sure if that really gave me an advantage in this scenario. Yeah, but finally I can get Ryla's scepter. I should have maybe built Mercury Treads before, just because Darius' tears are magic damage. And Mercury Treads, or at least the Negatron Cloak, are a good way to soften the damage up for you. Also, it's of course nice to have movement speed on Singed, but he got a rather good natural movement speed. And he got his ultimate, and you also should pick Ghost. An enemy has So, I have some movement speed if I need it, some boosts. And now I also have the Rylai's passive, which is great. Not only does it give 10% slow if anyone walks into my gas. When I fling somebody, he will actually get like 30, I think, is Rylai's scepter on single target spells, which my fling is. So if you fling somebody, he will be very slow afterwards. Which is a very nice thing, of course, if some ganking or team fighting happens. But right now, this new design with turrets giving the players shields and stupid stuff, I cannot fight Darius on good terms on this tower. So I decided to go mid. I think I should have just walked actually mid and not waited there. I waited for Lee Sin to come to have a proper 3 gank, but it seemed to be warded or something. I'm just trying to keep Ping Darius off Lee Sin, who's stealing the blue. And right now I'm really, really stupid again. I mean, you have to be cocky with Singed. And I maybe thought Lee Sin would still be there, but yeah. As you can see, three people will bring you down pretty fast. Especially if all of them do magic damage and the only thing you got is armor. Yeah, I thought about this after the game, and if you do the math on my magic resistance, it's really bad because like an AP damage dealer will have like natural 10 magic penetration and maybe an additional 5%, I think. And also, and if he buys then some magic penetration like boots or other item, I will get pretty close to the zero with my 40 something. I will be at, yeah, something like 10 magic resistance, which is really tough. But yeah, on the other hand, I wanted to buy the Rylai's early, which is also normally a good thing to do. So not really a mistake there, just something to think about. Against Darius, the armor was pretty pointless, I think, since, like I said, the tier stackings, which do a lot of damage to me, are magic damage. And his ultimate is doing absolute damage, so there's no point in getting anything against it except for life or HP. The mid lane and also the jungler are AP damage dealers, very heavy AP damage dealers even. So early Negatron Cloak or even Mercury Treads would have been a good option. But now I'm getting stupid Darius. And I'm not sure. I should look at some point at the CS, I'm not sure when. But I have a big CS advantage over Darius, and this is like the important thing with Singed. It's not that easy to kill people with Singed, to be honest. Just because everybody who plays halfway careful, won't get killed. If you play stupid or too brave or something, or if you chase Singed, which I just had in like a few days ago in the game, I had like 4 people chasing me for 20 seconds around the map and running through my gas constantly. That was fun. But yeah, as long as you are staying calm against Singed and use the fact that I got no special closing in tool except for my movement speed, but I don't got like any dash or any kind of that stuff. I got a area of effect slow, which is maybe one of the worst, some not one of the worst abilities in the whole game. It, I mean, it delays you when you cast it, it's really weak in the beginning. And maybe at full level 5 it can do some stuff, but yeah, it's easy to dodge. It's hard to forecast where you would where would be an optimal place to put your W. So yeah, the W is a really, really bad thing. Yeah, I could have got the big blue rod there. I should really learn the name of the items if I want to do some kind of guide or stuff. But I decided to go for magic penetration and more armor for some reason. I'm not sure why the more armor, maybe just because I could buy it, but I mostly wanted to get the magic penetration because at this point I figured out that I'm doing pretty good and I should get damage if I'm doing good. It's not that tough to survive with Singed, it's tough to kill with Singed. Just because you mostly do damage over time and enemies have to be really stupid to die to damage over time. But this Darius obviously is stupid enough. Yeah. And again, I survive with very low HP. But that's normal. That's a side effect of it being not easy to kill other people. You normally get very low because people won't stick to a full HP Singed. There's just no reason to run close to him, so people won't get into your poison. So you won't do any damage to them. It's like pretty easy math. Yeah, and that's the game for it. I hope you enjoyed it so far. If you have more questions about Singed or disliked or liked something about this video, please tell me in the comments. Goodbye.